Welcome to part two of the True Cost of Ferrets video series. Make sure to check out part one, linked below, where I cover the initial upfront costs associated with a ferret, like the range in price for the ferrets themselves, as well as the necessary supplies to keep them safe and healthy. In this video, however, I'm gonna go over how much annual vet visits cost, how much vaccines currently cost, how much it costs to treat common illnesses like insulinoma and adrenal disease, and end-of-life costs. I'll also tally everything up from part one and part two at the end of this video to give you a grand total of how much it costs over the course of an entire lifespan for a ferret. Let's get started. Typically, a healthy ferret should be seen by their vet at least once a year. My vet charges $44 for an exam. They also charge $27.50 for an annual rabies vaccine. Ferrets also need distemper vaccines every 3 years, which costs $44. Some owners give their ferrets flea medication during the summer months, so this is another additional cost to consider. Based on these numbers, assuming your ferret has all the supplies they need and they don't have any major health problems, annual vet expenses would be around $80 to $100. If your ferret gets a common illness like insulinoma or adrenal disease, they'll need more regular checkups and more routine tests. With insulinoma, your vet will need to check their blood glucose levels regularly during treatment. At my vet, this test costs about $13, and she likes to do it regularly as the illness progresses. There's a medication called prednisolone that's used to partly treat insulinoma. I say partly because the medication doesn't cure the disease. With my last ferret, it cost $20 per month and then $40 per month when he needed a higher dose as the disease progressed. With adrenal disease, your ferret will need to get something called a desflurellin implant every 6 to 18 months, depending on your ferret's symptoms. At my friend's vet, they cost around $252. When Moose had the end of his tail amputated due to a large chordoma, it cost a total of $586. To test what I thought was a tumor on my other ferret Newt's neck, it cost $116. Albert had surgery on his tail to have it amputated due to a particularly bloody, inflamed, and recurring mast cell tumor. And the grand total for that was $752, although that did include a dental x-ray and a teeth cleaning for $160. When I went to an out-of-state vet center to try to figure out what to do about Moose's egg-sized cyst in his belly, I spent $385 on tests alone, like x-rays, complete blood counts, and a full chemistry panel. A lot of times an emergency vet appointment will cost a lot more than a standard visit. For instance, I called a local 24-hour emergency vet clinic here in town, and their initial exam fee is $180. Compared to my regular vet who charges $44 for a scheduled appointment. Toward the end of his life, as Moose got sicker, we had to do some emergency appointments and testing. We did an analysis of his persistent diarrhea and combined with another test and the recommended medication, that all cost $450. An ultrasound was done around this time, which was another $480. I asked our community to provide their own numbers for various costs associated with vet care, both routine and emergency procedures and costs. So feel free to take a look at those numbers too. At the end of Moose's life, there were at least $1,500 worth of vet expenses, including numerous tests and medications. When we ultimately decided to put him down, euthanasia itself was $60, and a necropsy was $100. Let's get back to our calculations for this one. According to Ferrets for Dummies, ferrets live an average of 7 years, so I'm gonna base these numbers off of a ferret who lived that full length of time. We know that all the total upfront costs totaled $1,172. And per month, Eli costs around $42, which times 12 is $504 per year, and times 7 for a 7-year lifespan is $3,528. Now let's add the cost of likely health problems. For instance, Eli is 3 years old and just got his first desflurellin implant, which at my vet is $300. He'll need that replaced on average every 12 months for another 4 years, which is another $1,200 total. He'll also need to see the vet for regular exams, which would have been $308 for 7 total, assuming I got him as a baby, at a frequency of 1 per year. His vaccines will cost an average of $42 per year, or $294 for 7 years. I hope he doesn't, but Eli may end up getting something like insulinoma a couple years from now at age 5, which once diagnosed would be another $30 per month for medication on average for another 2 years of life expectancy after that. That would equal $720. It would also mean at least 2 more vet visits per year, roughly $100 each, including blood glucose and other various tests, totaling an additional $800. Based on my own personal experience, we can guess that Eli will have at least 3 more emergency vet visits in his lifetime, and with tests and exams, this could easily add another $1,500. End-of-life costs would probably be another $500 for additional tests to confirm his condition and make some tough calls. Not fun to think about, but necessary if you're truly considering this pet. All of this comes out to a grand total of, are you ready for it? $10,022. So, are ferrets expensive? According to a recent study by a research company called Synchrony, people spend an average of $15,000 to $45,000 on a cat over the course of their lifetime, and $20,000 to $55,000 for a dog. Compared to those numbers, ferrets might seem relatively cheap. However, as you can see, stuff like chronic illnesses and surprise vet bills can really break the bank. In my opinion, if finding a budget-friendly pet is priority number 1 on your list, this may not be the pet for you. Were you guys surprised by the numbers I provided? How do they stack up with your own personal experience? I would love to hear in the comment section below. I don't think a lot of us actually take the time to calculate a lifetime's worth of pet expenses, which is probably why these numbers might sound pretty surprising. At least they did for me. I hope you found this video helpful, and if this was weaselly the best thing you've seen all day, make sure to like and subscribe. Bye! Oh, you gotta go too. Okay, bye. Bye!